Welcome to Politics Unplugged. I'm Anne Trujillo, and tomorrow is a big day for immigration. The president is expected to announce a plan that he says will include a path to citizenship for 700,000 dreamers covered by DACA, as well as those who meet DACA criteria but fail to sign up.
They do a great job. I think it's a nice thing to have the incentive of, after a period of years, being able to become a citizen.
Now, in exchange for this path to citizenship, the president is asking for $25 billion to pay for a border wall. Democrats haven't said if they'll agree to the deal. There's a lot more on the table with this proposal. Now, either way, though, both parties are up against two deadlines. The government will run out of money on February 8th, which could lead to a shutdown, and temporary work permits for people here under DACA expire on March 5th. Now, a few dozen people marched on Denver's Averia campus on Tuesday, pushing for a permanent solution to DACA. And many of these protesters are dreamers who are hoping for action before they face possible deportation in March.
I check the news every 5 minutes to see where they are in these negotiations, to see whether they've added in poison pills that will make my parents more deportable. So I'm in a constant state of anxiety.
And right now, the White House is fighting a federal judge's order that would stop the administration from phasing out DACA. They have taken this challenge all the way to the U.S. Supreme Court. And at last check, the justices have been asked to fast track this case. And it could be up for discussion as early as February 16th. Well, joining us now to talk more about these developments is Cristian Solano-Córdova, the Colorado Immigrant Rights Coalition. And thank you for being here. I know the president has his plan that he's to reveal tomorrow. How are you feeling about this?
So much anticipation. He did reveal a few details of his plan, kind of an outline here yesterday. So we have an idea of what he's going to propose, but as always, the devil's in the details. So I'm excited to see those details tomorrow.
I know the border wall is, the bill, or this plan at least, is tied to the border wall. And some people say that that holds dreamers hostage. Is that how you feel about it?
Absolutely. It's not even just the border wall, because that was already offered in the last deal and the president refused to take that deal. What I think the biggest issue with this proposal is the attacks on legal immigration. We all know the president is very well known for his attacks on what he calls illegal immigration, but he's been consistently attacking legal immigration. With these comments he's made about, quote-unquote, S-hole countries and wanting more immigration from Norway, to me it seems like it's just very racially motivated, trying to cut off any future flows of immigration, including the racial diversity visa. Why the president would want to get rid of racial diversity in this country, I don't know. That's up to the public to decide. But, to me, it's he's trying to pass his whole frankly, white supremacist immigration agenda on the backs of our dreamers. And, I think a vast majority of the American public supports dreamers and wants to see a pathway to citizenship, but these ever-increasing demands from the president make it seem like it's not a good faith effort on his part to negotiate.
And when you see Congress and hear the words from Congress and you hear what the president is saying, do you feel like they're negotiating in good faith and in your best interest?
I have personally been in meetings with Senator Michael Bennet and Senator Cory Gardner. I know they are definitely good people and they actually care about this issue. We've had people in Cory Gardner's like hometown who are DACA recipients go talk to his family, and I think that's really what changed his mind and made him realize that they were his community too. I'm confident that they're trying to work out a realistic deal, but the outline that's coming from the White House just doesn't seem like a compromise at all. It seems more like a demand.
So you feel like our U.S. senators are at least listening to your messaging here?
Yeah, I think we've been definitely upset at them that they didn't push harder for a deal this last time, and I think recent polling has shown that their approval numbers have dropped. Whether that's just because of immigration, that's not for me to say, but I know that they've been working hard at it. They didn't come to a conclusion to negotiations this last time. Mm-hmm. But I'm confident they're putting a good faith effort into it.
I know the president said that this legislation or this plan would morph into possible citizenship for Dreamers. Is that what Dreamers want?
You know, that's exactly what the Dream Act is. Oftentimes I hear, like, why don't they just get in line? They've had 20 years to apply for citizenship. What most people don't understand is there is no line for citizenship. That's the whole point of a Dream Act, to establish a pathway for citizenship for people like me. The problem is the president doesn't just want this bill to pass. He is holding this bill hostage in exchange for his whole anti-immigrant, anti-people of color agenda.
So let's say nothing happens. What happens? What are your thoughts about your future if we're looking at a March deadline?
Yeah, you know, I caught an interview with Senate Minority Leader Chuck Schumer, he made a comment that, you know, if come March 6th the deportations begin, that's not good PR for the president or the president's party. Well, I agree, but it shouldn't come to that. And it seems like every day that we wait, both sides are politically posturing to keep this debate going onto the 2018 election. Mm-hmm. And it seems like both sides are using it for fodder to rile up their bases. And frankly, I think both parties are using us as political pawns.
So with less than a minute here, what would you like to say to people who are sitting on the sidelines watching this happen?
You know, I'm a dreamer. I work two jobs to pay for my degree. I pay local taxes, I pay state taxes, I pay federal taxes, I pay into Medicare, I pay into Medicaid, I pay into Social Security, and I'll never be eligible for those benefits. Who am I burdening? You know, not being political about immigration means being complicit in my deportation. So that's why I need every single person to call your legislator today, especially in the House, because the Senate, you know, they may have a gentleman's agreement going on, but many Republican leaders in this House say they're not bound by that same agreement.
Are you anxious? Are you scared?
You know, I think every single one of us is. I think it's not, I can't deny that there's, you know, a fear being deported to a country I haven't ever been to since I was a child. I'm scared, but I'm more hopeful and I'm more confident in the good people of our country.
All right, Cristian, thank you so much for being here and giving us your insight. We will be watching this week to see what this proposal holds. We'll be right back.